All right, today is the day, and we are looking at building some hinges for the doors. Not quite ready to install the doors themselves. We have some other fiberglass work we have to do on the floor, door sills and things like that, that doors will be fitting up against. But we do have some things that have accomplished that are helping us to move into that direction. One of those things being is that front subframe is actually mounted solidly into the bulkheads at that front. And so we can start doing things like attaching that front clamshell and the door hinges. I'm doing those door hinges because there have to be some holes through that front bulkhead area, and we need to get those accomplished before we can move on with some other things. So anyway, we're gonna look at that hinge, the hinge system on the door. We have had to change that a little bit. In earlier video, I showed you a pneumatic cylinder that we were gonna be using, but we have had to change our mind due to some extraneous circumstances around the placement of that door. Anyway, let's jump in, take a look at building the door hinges. So all of this hinges around me getting this front subframe in place. Now it fits nice and tightly around the footwell area, and it's all reinforced through there, and that allows me to get final bolting in place to start making these parts. Now this hinge assembly is going to be made out of a piston and a cylinder. Cylinder made out of aluminum tube, so I just chucked it up in the lathe, give it a good cleaning, run some sandpaper down it, make it nice and shiny. And then the piston that goes inside is fairly long, and we're going to cut it down. It makes it nice and smooth to fit the bore of that cylinder. Also cut some grooves in it that will later on I'll be putting some Teflon bushings in there to give it a little better action sliding in the piston. But for now, we'll try it just like it is, just to test this whole prototype out. One end of that piston is going to have a couple of brackets welded to it that will fit and hold a piece of the hinge that swings out and pivots around the bodywork of the car. So I'm just going to machine a couple of flat surfaces that those little water jet cut pieces will fit on. And then weld those pieces in place, make it one little bracket on the end for holding that hinge section. Then it's how to assemble this whole thing. This is the mounting or the base plate for the whole hinge assembly. It's got kind of a round curved end. It's also going to be a cam mechanism. It's gonna make a profile to force the hinge to travel in a certain pattern. But we'll get our piston and plunger all set up. Once it was welded to our base plate, I'm gonna take it over and machine a little groove in it. One of the problems without this groove is that that piston inside the cylinder could rotate around and the hinge could be able to rotate in an arc outside of the line we want it to stay in. So we're going to put this groove in here to force it into one position. And once we get that groove cut through, we need to take the piston and put it in there and then mark a hole, because what we're going to do is put a little cap head screw through the cylinder into the piston itself. So with that piston chucked up in the milling machine, I'm gonna drill a little hole that we marked and then go in there and tap that hole as well. That'll accept the little cap head screw that's gonna be our guide. Now I'll just throw in here as one of those little tips and tricks of the trade, but when you're working in aluminum, best way to lubricate for a tap and die is with some paraffin wax, plus a little less messy than cutting fluid. But once that's threaded, we got a little hole in there, our cap head screw goes in, and that keeps this thing, like I said, from being able to rotate. Now here's all the components together. Originally, when I was looking to do an electronic actuator, they were either way too expensive, or I would find them on Amazon or eBay, and they would have crappy reviews, failed after 7 strokes or whatever. So one day I noticed on my wife's new van that the lift hatch in the back had this fantastically compact actuator, only about 1 3/8 in diameter, a little longer than I'd liked, but it was cheap enough to fit within my budget. Now this is a little ball joint that came with the actuator, and it's gonna fit right inside that hinge piece. Now this red piece is the main hinge. It's curved like this so that it will swing around the bodywork. This is another piece of it that will hook to the car itself or the door. And these pieces are made out of PLA so that I can cast them in aluminum. Here's a little bearing that will fit on the backside of that red piece, and it will travel along this surface on the base plate, which is kind of a cam mechanism, like I said,
to force the hinge into a certain pattern of travel. And I'll show you what I'm talking about. There it is. So in the stroke, it travels forward before it moves up. So this is located right behind the tire in the fender well. So this thing will have to have a box built around it to keep it from the elements, but we'll get it in there installed now, get this prototype checked out and tweak it in. But it mounts with some bolts right through the fender well wall. I won't call it the firewall because that's behind the driver's feet. But the little bolts go through and you can access them from under the dashboard. Now there will be another hole will have to be cut right about the same, really close to where I'm drilling right now. And that is where the actuator will come through and it will mount under the dashboard. So here it is in place. That's where the fender, or the door panel will be. And when the actuator pushes this whole mechanism forward, it'll come forward and then swing up so that that arced hinge clears all the bodywork right over the windshield. And then when the actuator pulls it back, it'll come down and then pull it in into place. Now here's a little bonus. This is the upper hinge. Two little brackets are going to be connected together with a piece of a hinge, but I found a novelty item here that usually, instead of using a real arc like you have to do on a lot of these like gullwing doors, which would hang down into your cavity of your vehicle on the ceiling, I'm using this little piece of chain out of a four-wheel drive transfer case. One of these pieces of aluminum hinge will bolt to the bodywork, one to the door, but it will lay nice and flat against the ceiling. And then when the other hinge mechanism opens the bottom side, it will swing the door up into that position. Anyway, as I mentioned, these PLA pieces that I had in the prototype here are going to be cast in aluminum. These are three of the hinges all printed up with the sprue mechanism that will all be burned away in the ceramic shell and cast in aluminum.
Well, there you are. You have seen the door hinges. We do have some other things to do. Always something more that has to be done to move on to the next step. And of course, we will be installing those actuator cylinders by doing some welding of some brackets on that tube that crosses over under the dashboard. But that will have to be in another video. Anyway, if you're interested in how that whole sub-assembly attaches under there, what we had to do to get that point, I will put a video up right over here that will take you back to a couple of those videos that show working area around those things. Anyway, thanks for coming by. Come back, see us again.